On the occasion, Srimati Kumar observed that at the time of independence, quite a few were skeptical about India's ability to sustain democracy. There were insurmountable challenges of poverty, illiteracy, ethnic and linguistic diversity, castes and classes, and the rural base of the economy. Despite these odds, democracy in India has flourished. Come elections, and the man who otherwise did not count suddenly becomes the most sought after. Lok Sabha Speaker stated that during elections, generally the deciding factor is the caste, which is discussed in hushed tones behind closed doors. It is argued that consolidation along caste lines during elections leads to empowerment of Dalits. They get an opportunity to assert themselves. She, however, felt that this is a mirage. Caste system has caused and is continuing to cause unimaginable harm to the society. She asserted that caste system needs to be destroyed completely and not encouraged to lighten its grip on our electoral system. Observing that religion is another factor which plays a role in elections, she said that any communal approach or activity is not beneficial for India's secular fabric.
Cambridge represents an intellectual vigor, ferocity, debates, discussions, and discovery that aim to change the world for the better. Indian politics does the same. It embraces the dreams and aspirations of the people. It sends people's representatives to the parliament so that they can change their lives for the better. A very Gandhian, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, I felt was a study in contrast against the splendor of his presidential palace. Pandit Nehru would smile and offer me cakes whenever my parents took me to his house. I now realize how fortunate I was to be growing up in such close proximity to greatness. History was being scripted, and though a child, I was witness to it. In the wake of independence, India was charting a new course for itself. All these men and women and many more spread across the country were at that time engaged in laying a strong foundation for democracy in our land. At the time of independence, quite a few were skeptical about India's ability to sustain democracy. There were insurmountable challenges of poverty, illiteracy, ethnic and linguistic diversity, castes and classes, and the rural base of the economy. All these militated against India's transition to democracy. I would be happy if India's future. Professors and students of Cambridge University visit us in our parliament. Built in 1927, this red sandstone circular building with elegant columns is the nerve center of the largest functioning democracy of the world. I'm taking steps to preserve its heritage character. As you are aware, we have adopted the Westminster model with the executive being accountable to the legislature. There are 39 parties in the Sabha. Each elected member sits in the House with the responsibility of approximately 2,200,000 constituents. It is a pleasure to reckon with. I want to inform you that I'm very proud of my members and hold them in high esteem for their caliber.